Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and I was recently reading about Carl Jung's work on a particular archetype. It's called the tormented healer or the damaged healer. The notion is that a lot of people who work in healing related fields, such as counseling, therapy, medicine, are people that themselves have strong emotional issues, traumas, or feeling inside of having been damaged or having been hurt. And I thought about this in my own view of self in regards to how I see myself and why I do what I do. And I think about it when I read Carl Jung's works, realizing that Carl Jung's works came from some form of self-absorption. Carl Jung was preoccupied with his own life and his own struggles. He went through a lot of very difficult and traumatic experiences, and it was by confronting and becoming aware of this that he was able to find insight and remedies that he could share with the world to make the world come to a higher level of understanding of and acceptance of self. And in this healing, he wanted to understand himself and he wanted to heal his own wounds, and he wanted to take his understanding and he wanted to help heal other people as well with the understanding he had found. So I think about this archetype a lot because there's another particularly interesting character, you know, in comic books. There's this idea of Iron Man, you know. Iron Man, he's the inventor. And Carl Jung, he always said the healer and the inventor and the magician, they're all kind of related. They all come from a very strong sense of ego, a self-absorption, a focus on self and the inner state or your personal experience, and on providing solutions and fulfilling wishes and healing wounds, in a sense. Iron Man's powers came from his own injuries, often self-inflicted injuries, like having damaged yourself or having become damaged by your own weapons or by something you have done, taking an injury to your pride almost in all of this. And in this, he gained the power to create the suit and machines that would keep him alive, that would remedy his own issues and save his heart and save himself from death. And in this, he would get the power to become a superhero. So the thought was, this suit, these inventions would keep him alive and they would heal him. And they would even restore his powers beyond his original capacity. So that is what the healer in a way does. It brings out potential, it heals, it fixes, it puts right, but then it puts better even still. And here I feel that there is a tendency, you know, to consider that we are intuitives. Like, well, not all of us, but some of us are intuitives and we're focused on dreams or innovation. And you know, when you come from that perspective of innovation, as I think Iron Man does, it's very common to see healing as a process of innovation rather than fixing or maintenance. It's not about maintaining as much as it is as innovating. Healing is not about putting right, but it is improving. Healing is not keeping things the same way they used to work, but it is putting them in a better way. So it's constantly rearranging and putting things better. That's the innovator. Now, personally, I feel like I'm the dreamer. And in this, I feel like what I'm about to do, what I do, is not to make people just feel better. It's not when somebody's struggling, it's not to just say, hey, just be happy, just smile, and it will go away. It's not to start a motivational series of videos where I say, just be happy, just think positive. I'm not so focused on mindset. I'm not so focused on that just pure experience of happiness, that just general experience of happiness. It's almost as if I shudder at the thought of happiness that comes out of nowhere, that doesn't come from your dreams, that doesn't come from your like higher aspirations or ideals. It's as if I feel like happiness must come through a process, that it must come from the fulfillment of one's dreams and from reaching a higher existential state. It must come from self-transformation. And so I realize what I do is I'm not a healer, I am a transformer in a sense of I don't want to make people feel better, but I want them to grow beyond their present state to a higher state. I want them to find new things about themselves that they didn't know they had. I want people to look inside, and of course I want to look inside myself, and I want to transform myself too. And here I find myself thinking about my current experience, you know. Actually, at the moment, I run a YouTube channel with 7,000 subscribers. I have 30 backers on Patreon. I have a really sweet Facebook community, a really amazing Discord community. Like, we have conversations every day. We talk about all kinds of subjects. We share videos from all kinds of YouTubers. Currently, a lot of Dave's Superpowers, but also Academy of Ideas. Sometimes Jordan B. Peterson, like all kinds of different intellectuals and thinkers with different perspectives on life and who we are. I watch all kinds of YouTubers talking about the personal experience and on personal growth and who we are and what we can be. And I feel like I am obsessed with that question, and I wonder, should I be? I find myself wondering how I could best promote personal growth, and I find myself wondering if perhaps my pursuit, obsession with self-transformation and with improving, and perhaps the injuries to my pride, you could say, my pride over who I am and where I am in life, and my feeling that I'm not where I'm supposed to be or I'm not quite right, is somehow keeping me from my mission of actually doing something, actually spreading a message that will further personal growth and self-help. And this might sound too abstract to even comprehend, but think about it like this. At the moment, I'm thinking about my personal experiences, and I'm thinking about how to grow myself, but I'm not thinking about my message. It's as if I don't have a message. It's as if I don't trust my own message. I have a message, it's there, but it's as if I don't trust it enough to speak it out. And here I feel like it's time to stop being a healer, and it's time to start being an influencer. And I love the word influencer. Like, I love the thought of not just spreading insight or just making people think about these thoughts, but making them feel it and giving people a sense of mission or a sense of some kind of story. And I feel like that's what YouTube should be about. You know, YouTube should bring together influencers, and it should be about your influence, what you want to say, your message. It should be about who you are and your message and what you believe in and your values. And I feel like perhaps what I gained from my past experiences, investigating myself and looking inside and finding out who I was, that was all good and well. Like, it's, there was nothing wrong with it, and there is nothing I want to stop doing. There is just something I want to start doing, and that is perhaps coming from a perspective of completeness. I had a discussion with my girlfriend a few weeks ago, and it still rings in my ears, you know, what we were talking about, what we were discussing. And for her, I feel like it was that she felt I was too focused on what was incomplete or what was wrong with myself, and I should be more focused on what was right. And here I feel like that is my message. Like, I want to start talking about what is right with us, and I want to promote positive reinforcement rather than negative reinforcement. I want to focus on making people aware of the good inside of them and bringing out those qualities and reaffirming those qualities. And I want people to take a step back and to keep on reminding themselves of that. I read recently that, you know, perfectionism has an easy remedy. They find that people that are perfectionists and struggle with perfectionism, if they can just take a few minutes every day to just practice self-love and to say kind words to themselves, it gets better. And you know, this is something very interesting. You know, it can be hard as a perfectionist to allow yourself to love yourself, to allow yourself to say you're good enough, to allow yourself to say you've done a good job, you've done your best, you've done great, you've done amazing. Like, it's hard to do it, and it feels wrong at first. But the thing is, the odd thing is, you don't have to believe it. You just have to say it to yourself. And something starts happening after you do. You say it a few times a day, just once in a while, you stop yourself. You say, "Hey, you're doing a good job. I'm doing a good job." Like, just keep going. Don't worry. Like, it will get better. You're doing all right. Things are okay. You know, when you just say these things and when you just practice self-love, it gets to the point where everything gets better. And suddenly the perfectionism you carry and the feeling of not being good enough and of having to improve yourself and having to fix yourself, it just eases up, and it's like your entire person eases up. You become more relaxing as a person, and you become more relaxed in what you do and in how you do it, and you become better. And you stop dwelling on the mistakes you made in how you executed your ideas in what you did. And you start focusing on what you did right, and that becomes something you remember, and that becomes something you take away from to the next day. So the next time you do it, you do all those things you did right yesterday again, and you expand on that. That's the thing. You ex positive ex affirmation ex expanded. Compliment a person for doing something, and the next time they do it even better. That's really the strange thing, the strangest thing. Tell them they did something good, and they want to do it more often. Tell them they did something bad, and they're focused on not doing it again. This drives a decrease in productivity. The more I think about the mistakes I made at work, the less productive I become, more inhibited I become, the less well, the worse I do. And you know, that goes for perfectionists as well. Perfectionists are people that don't want to make mistakes. Perfectionists are not people that want to do things right. Perfectionists are people that don't want to make mistakes, and that's very, very different. So you have to think about what do you want. Do you want to do things right, or do you want to not make things wrong? So that's just my takeaway from this. You know, introspection is a positive thing, it's a great thing. Self-reflection is a positive thing, it's a great thing. But it has to come from a position of self-love. And sometimes I have to wonder if the damaged healer is also a person that is inflicting harm on themselves voluntarily, bringing themselves into positions of pain and hurt, forcing themselves to confront it, and bringing it to themselves, injuring themselves almost, just to bring out a process of stress and a feeling of having to grow and having to change and having to do something differently. Instead of coming from a perspective of feeling good about yourself and reflecting on who you are and what you love and what is important on you, constantly injuring yourself and harming yourself, and then reflecting on those negative feelings that brings up. And the question then is, of course, as a healer, do you need to harm yourself to be able to heal other people and to be able to heal? Do you need to harm to heal? Do you need to bring suffering to bring peace and remedy? Or can you find peace and remedy? Can you find a solution to suffering from a position of inner peace and well-being and self-acceptance? Thank you all for watching this video, and I hope to see you all in the next one.